monosaccharide units in their structure. So these two saccharides may be of same type or of different types. So same monosaccharide or different monosaccharides. So two types of disaccharides can be seen, reducing disaccharide and non-reducing disaccharide. So reducing disaccharides means they are having the free functional group in their structure. Examples for reducing disaccharide, we have maltose and lactose. Non-reducing disaccharide, it is not having a free functional group in its structure. Non-reducing disaccharide, we have example called sucrose. So maltose and lactose, these are reducing disaccharide. Non-reducing disaccharide example is sucrose. So maltose is a reducing disaccharide. Maltose is a reducing disaccharide. Sources of maltose, if you see, germinating seeds, germinating cereals, malt, and digestion of starch by amylase also yields this maltose. And ozogen crystals are the confirmatory test for the identification of maltose. So maltose on ozogen test, it gives an yellow colored sunflower shaped crystals. Maltase is the enzyme which converts this maltose into free glucose molecules. Now if you see the structure of maltose, maltose is made up of two glucose units. So D-glucose is the repeating unit in the maltose. So both the glucose molecules in the maltose are linked by a glycosidic bond. See, this is a glucose first carbon, this is another glucose molecule, but this is fourth carbon. So first carbon of one glucose, the fourth carbon of another glucose molecule are involved in the glycosidic bond formation. So this is called as alpha-1,4 glycosidic bond. So in the maltose, two glucose molecules are linked by alpha-1,4 glycosidic linkage. So glucose is two repeating units present in the maltose. So maltose is made up of two glucose monosaccharide units. They are linked by alpha-1,4 glycosidic linkage. And you can see here, this is the shape of the maltosogen crystals which are produced on ozogen test. So maltose on ozogen reaction, it forms maltosogen. So these are sunflower shaped crystals, or the crystals looks like the petal shape of the sunflower. So these are called maltosogen, and this ozogen test for maltose is the confirmatory test. Then another disaccharide is lactose. So lactose is another reducing disaccharide, mainly present in the milk, and yellow colored ozogen crystals are produced, and these ozogen crystals, lactosogen crystals, are hedgehog shaped or cotton ball shape or head of the pin, or else they look like powder puff shape. And lactase is the enzyme which can hydrolyze the lactose. If you see the structure of lactose, lactose is made up of galactose and glucose. So galactose is D-galactose and D-glucose. Now here it is a beta D-glucose, and the link present between galactose and glucose is beta-1,4 glycosidic linkage. So galactose and glucose in the lactose are linked by beta-1,4 glycosidic linkage. So lactosogen shape of the crystals, ozogen crystals produced by lactose, that is lactosogen. So these are yellow colored hedgehog shape or pin cushion or flower of touch me not plant looks like this only. So lactosogen crystals can be produced on reaction with ozogen. So this is a confirmatory test for the lactose. So another disaccharide, example for disaccharide is sucrose. Sucrose is a non-reducing disaccharide. It is mainly present in the sugarcane, beetroot sugar, sorghum, carrots, pineapple. They are mainly consist of this sucrose. And this is a non-reducing disaccharide. It does not form ozogens on hydrolysis. The products have reducing property. So sucrose on hydrolysis becomes reducing sugar, but before that it is a non-reducing sugar. If you see the structure of sucrose, you can see here, it is made up of D-glucose and D-fructose. alpha D glucose and beta D fructose. Now, the second carbon of fructose and the first carbon of glucose are involved in the linkage. You know that first carbon of glucose is having aldehyde group and the second carbon of fructose is having keto functional group. Now, both the functional groups in this glucose and fructose are involved in glycosidic bond formation. There is no free functional group available in the sucrose, so it is called non-reducing disaccharide. So the glycosidic bond in the sucrose is alpha beta 1,2 glycosidic linkage. Alpha beta 1,2 glycosidic linkage. So sucrose is also called as invert sugar, and when you hydrolyze the sucrose, they become reducing sugar. So hydrolysis of the sucrose can be done by an enzyme called sucrase. Otherwise, it is also called as invertase. This sugar is called invert sugar because the levorotatory fructose is produced and it causes the dextrorotatory action of sucrose into levorotatory. As the sugar which is dextrorotatory is becoming levorotatory, it is called as invert sugar. It is called as invert sugar. Then polysaccharides. Up to now we have discussed about monosaccharide.